नमस्ते फ्रेंड्स, आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल थर्मल टॉक्स। सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द कंबाइंड हीट ट्रांसफर मैकेनिज्म। नाउ लेट अस टेक अ ह्यूमन बीइंग हु हैज अ बॉडी टेम्परेचर 37 डिग्री सेल्सियस, सरफेस एरिया 1.6 मीटर स्क्वायर एंड ह्यूमन स्किन इज वेरी गुड, हैज वेरी गुड एमिसिविटी। आई हैव टेकन इट एज 0.95, यूजुअली इट can reach up to 0.98 also. Now let us see, the human being is exposed to surrounding atmosphere. If it is a summer, then the average ambient temperature would be 35 degrees Celsius and convective heat transfer coefficient, I have taken 50 watt per meter square degree Celsius. So let us calculate what will be the convective heat transfer from the body. So convective heat transfer is equal to H into surface area into surface temperature minus ambient temperature. So I'm going to get some 160 watts of energy will be transferred from the body to the surrounding through convection because of fluid interaction. Now I have a radiation heat transfer as well, emissivity, Stefan-Boltzmann constant, surface temperature and ambient temperature, and I got around 20.3 watts. So together during summer, where body temperature is 37 degree, which is constant, and in summer the temperature I have taken 35 degree Celsius, for that the total heat transfer by the person is 363 watt. And when I take it to a condition of winter, when ambient temperature is 15 degree Celsius and convective heat transfer coefficient is 35, then I can calculate convective heat transfer is 1232 watts and radiation heat transfer is 203, and together is around 1435. So it is very clear from this numerical that in summer the body tend to lose less heat than the winter. So I guess that is a case why we feel cold during winter seasons but not in summer season. And it is very important to understand, from the surface of the human body both convection and radiation is taking place. And what about the conduction? Here there is no conduction, but there is a internal heat generation within the body. So body generates internal heat generation. So because of that, the average temperature, average body temperature is 27 degrees Celsius. Let us take this metal sphere suddenly taken out from oven, maintained at constant temperature throughout the body from its center to its surface. Now it is allowed to cool down under atmospheric conditions of ambient air temperature T infinity. And then what happens now? At first, surface of the sphere which is exposed to ambient air starts losing its heat by convection as well as radiation. As outer surface loses heat, then temperature of the surface of the body starts decreasing. And simultaneously, the temperature difference is created between the surface and immediate inner layer, and thus conduction starts occurring within the body. The conduction begins from the center of high temperature region to the surface of low temperature region, and surface loses its heat to surrounding until thermal equilibrium is attained. Thus convection is happening due to bulk fluid motion of air particle is coming in contact with hot solid surface, and conduction is happening within the solid medium due to temperature difference from its center to its surface. Then what about radiation? Radiation is a volumetric phenomena, but radiation emitted by solid materials never reach the surface, and radiation incident on the material is usually absorbed within few microns from the surface itself. So we generally call radiation as a surface phenomena. So from the surface itself, radiation is also happening. So I can show it from this presentation that the conduction happens within the material, radiation and convection happens at the surface. So radiation, convection are surface phenomena. Now under steady state condition, I can write the rate of heat transfer by the conduction within the material is equal to rate of heat transfer by convection and rate of heat transfer by radiation from the material surface. So It is very important to understand conduction happens within the body, radiation and convection happens at the surface. Although we have three types of heat transfer mechanisms, but a particular medium may involve only two of them simultaneously. So for example, if it is an opaque solid material, then only conduction will happen within the material. If it is a transparent and semi-transparent solid material, conduction and radiation may happen. Why? Because if I take a transparent material as glass, then it has a capacity to pass through thermal radiation through it. So there may be a chance of passing conduction as well as radiation through transparent and semi-transparent solid material. When I take a bulk fluid motion, liquid or gases for that matter, the convection as well as radiation happens. We know that radiation doesn't require medium, but we know that ozone layer, which absorbs the ultraviolet radiations. So for certain contaminations in atmosphere, like greenhouse gases, which absorb certain wavelengths of radiation. So in general, we can say that presence of bulk fluid motion is necessary for convection, as well as some fluid particles absorbs radiation. And in vacuum, there is only radiation. So by these different materials, we can say that at any given medium, there are only two modes of heat transfer happen simultaneously. If all three modes of heat transfer has to happen, then it will happen at the surface. So conduction will happen within the material, and radiation and convection will happen at the surface. So that is it for today. I hope you have liked the presentation. I request you to subscribe to my channel and share this video among your friends. See you then. Till next time.